You're watching the Sean and
Tamara show.
And it's September! As we said, it's Peace Month. And today we're looking at two things. We're looking at human security, as well as the International Day of Peace, because one of our favorite days of the year is coming up. One of our favorite, when I say our, I mean family. Yeah. But us, it's one of my favorite days. Friday.
Yeah.
So tomorrow.
I love Fridays, because it's weekend. Well, besides that,
yes,
it's next week, Friday, 21st, and it's Peace Day, International Day of Peace.
To celebrate the International Day of Peace, because it is a very important thing, because peace is something we all can share, and peace is cool.
It is.
Anyway, that's
peace. Yeah.
Okay, so we're looking at Women, Peace, and Human Security, also known as Human Security. And we at Femlink use the United Nations Security Council Resolution 1325, which focuses on women, peace, and human security. And it's about preventing conflict through the participation, prevention of conflict,
promotion,
you know, it's also about involving women in the kinds of, you know, decision-making processes so that we can prevent conflict. Now, when it comes to human security, Tamara, what is human security?
Well, basically, human security is about making sure that you have your basic necessities provided. You have access to proper health, sanitation, food, have money and finance enough to make sure that you send children off to school, and also simple things such as having street lights so that you're able to walk out into the streets in the night, because that's your basic human rights. You're allowed to walk anywhere. And especially like for young women coming back from school late at night, you'd want them to be walking safely home and make sure that they reach home. There's a lot of range to human security.
And that's the thing. The other week, sorry, missed a week because I was unwell and stuff. But also the thing is, the traditional security sector is one thing.
Yeah.
Human security focuses on the very human aspects of feeling secure. There's your economic security, there's your community, there's your environment, there's your personal, which is one of the things you mentioned. It's about having streetlights so that, you know, you're not walking in the dark and you're not feeling a little bit scared, because it's more likely that you're going to get, like, robbed or mugged or attacked or other things if it is dark, you know, because you won't be able to see their face and everything else. So it is about feeling safe and feeling secure, because it's security, and you feel secure, you feel comfortable, you're not worried about, like you said, sending your kids to school, you're not worried, like, you know, okay, I only have a temporary job, what am I going to do, you know, it's coming close to the end of the holidays for overseas gang, you know, will the hotel let me keep my job, that kind of stuff. So it's a lot of stuff, and when your human security needs are met, that is a situation in which it's likely to not have any sort of conflict within a community, within a country, within a state. So, you know, it's good, because when you adhere to these sort of security, human security concerns, you know, you're promoting peace, and that's what we all want.
Yes. And peace, well, peace is not just usually the calm. I mean, it is what the ideal picture is.
Yeah.
But then it's also about being able to agree to disagree and
compromise.
Yeah, compromising.
And you know, you're having these sort of things where you may not have everyone's wants met, but you know, you've come to a sort of decision where you can do the most good, and you know, you're addressing the key issues rather than addressing all like the tiny little things that probably don't matter. But you know, it is about peace is not necessarily the lack of conflict, but the ability to resolve conflict whenever it arises without it having to be a big thing, without it, you know, becoming armed conflict or, you know, political instability, manifesting in political instability. It's about that. It's about, you know, having your basic needs met to be able to address anything else that comes up. So, you know, because a lot of women can't engage in sort of decision-making positions, they don't feel empowered enough because they're still struggling to, you know, secure their basic sort of
needs and
needs, you know.
Yeah.
When you don't have your needs, there's no way in which you're going to be able to fully engage in you know, other kinds of things.
Yes, Sean. Which comes to, I mean, like, me thinking of, like, especially those with disabilities, and also, disabled people, as in including those with mental illness and that sort of stuff. Yeah, so for them, like, I mean, like, how do we make sure that their needs are also being met and this kind of, because I mean, like, for whereas us, we can, I mean, it's easy for us to go out and say things to able-bodied, but then whereas them, because of the stigmatization and the discrimination, they're sort of reluctant and hesitant to come out and simply like tell people, these are my needs, or where can I go for help?
Yeah.
So I guess it's also like having to work with those people with living with disabilities, and having to also being not the one waiting, but you go out and having. I mean, it's all about this, reaching out to others who are more in need of help than you are.
Yeah.
And I guess that's one of the things that really is
falls on the wayside. Yeah. But when you know, that's something that really needs to be focused on, I guess, is that while we can identify as young women, we can also admit the fact that we aren't the archetype. There's no kind of way in which you are as, you know, in any particular kind of ethnic group or any particular kind of where you live or what your gender is or you know, what your job is or anything. Mm. Because we people are so complex and so built on a whole bunch of different things that there needs to be an understanding that you have to cope with all the fact that so many people are so different, and you know, you can be completely different from your brother and sister who might look exactly like you, who might have come from exactly the same background, but the thing is, you know, you all have different needs, because, you know, a single woman will have different sort of focuses as, you know, perhaps a dude who has like three kids that he has to look after.
Yes.
Similarly, you might have a woman with one kind of disability, and her needs are completely different from another kind of, you know, person with disabilities. And it isn't until the sort of decision making processes themselves account for these kinds of issues that, you know, you can't really address them.
Yeah. So it's also been about inclusive rather than being exclusive and making sure that all the needs are met and it's tailored specific so that it can really, I mean, like, you would want to cater properly for the need of someone and not having to give something totally different.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah, so it's all about that. So it's really larger than just the word human security and peace. So it's really big, diverse.
So because it's so big and diverse, that is why peace is everyone's business, you know. We can't just have a small group of us, NGOs and CSOs, or maybe even including government officials, because it is their job to look after everyone.
Yeah.
You know, you can't just have them working for peace or for whatever their concept of peace is, because, you know, every NGO has their own different definition of peace, every individual has their own definition of peace, and it's that sort of addressing, you know, what are your human security concerns? But at the end of the day, it's everyone's business, because we are sharing a similar space, and while, you know, you might be in a completely different country, we're still sharing the world, you know.
Exactly.
We have to coexist in a way that, you know, we're considerate of the people, but we're also taking care of ourselves and our families, because without, you know, looking at home, you can't exactly go out and start preaching the word of peace, because that's a little bit strange in itself.
Everything starts from home.
It does. So this 21st of September, you know, think about peace. Well, Family Pacific is having a peace breakfast, and I think I might be hosting it because you have classes.
Yeah, and school commitments, unfortunately, we're also students.
Yes.
We have things called assignments and
Yes, I also have assignments, but I'm lucky in the way to say that I don't really have Friday morning classes.
I don't have Friday morning classes, it's just that it's a meeting.
And you know, it's her pursuing her education to address her future human security needs and concerns.
Yeah, so I can be more peaceful with myself.
Yes, you know,
so I don't have to worry about my economic security and my food security and my health security in the future.
Yeah, because they're all connected.
Yeah.
Especially the food one. So much
food. Yeah, so I guess a lot of whole list of NGOs around Fiji are also having celebrations in regards to peace. CCF is having, I guess, a drama, and ACCIA also hold their own peace stuff. Yeah, so that would be really interesting.
To see how, you know, everyone sort of bands together to acknowledge the common day that we all hold so dear. You know, maybe one day it'll be more of a commemoration rather than a hope. You know. But that's just us, and that is about it. I think we have another how many more episodes do we have this month?
This month. Yeah. Another two.
Alright.
Yeah.
So for the other two, we'll be bringing you some messages from some of our Generation X members, and perhaps also from the rest of our network. You know, we'll try and reach out to the gang who aren't necessarily into them, get them to send us a little bit some. But in case we don't, and in case, you know, the tapes don't come in on time, we might be bringing it as more of a special episode because, you know, peace is a 365-day thing. 365.25.
Yeah. Okay. So that's it from us, and that was the Sean and Tamara show.
We'll be back with more soon.